Hello, BookTubers. This is the long version of my Barnes & Noble haul. And if you didn't check out the short version, you'll want to check out at least the beginning of it and my little rant on Barnes & Noble and what happened to me today with my $100 order that I was standing there in line and what I got told. But anyway, you need to go watch at least the beginning of that if you want to. I also have some ephemera in there for book ephemera. I have a journal and some bookmarks that I will show real quickly here, but I've already shown them in the short haul. But I really like these bookmarks with the tassels on them. So this one here is the Oriental bookmark, and it's like a piece of carpeting. So, okay. Long haul. This is Ann Patchett, State of Wonder. Yes, the sticker is still there, as you can see. And saw this on Amazon as a current release. It just came out. And so I'm going to go ahead and read the synopsis for you on this. And the book is really cool, isn't it? And it's got the deckle edge. If you take the cover off here, I don't think there's anything all that special about it, other than it has Ann Patchett or AP or initials embossed, and there is the spine, which is cloth actually. Okay, so let me read the synopsis on here. This is kind of a long one. Sorry. Let's go here. Dr. Marina Singh, S-I-N-G-H, a research scientist with the Minnesota-based pharmaceutical company, is sent to Brazil to track down her former mentor, Dr. Annick Swenson, who seems to have all but disappeared in the Amazon while working on what is destined to be an extremely valuable new drug. Nothing about the assignment is easy. Not only does one know where Dr. Swenson is, but the last person who was sent to find her, Marina's research partner, Anders Ekman, died before he could complete his mission. Plagued by trepidation, Marina embarks on an odyssey into the insect-infested jungle in hopes of finding Dr. Swenson, as well as answers to troubling questions about her friend's death, the state of her company's future, and her own past. Once found, Dr. Swenson, now in her 70s, is as ruthless and uncompromising as she ever was back in the days of grand rounds at Johns Hopkins. With a combination of science and subterfuge, she dominates her research team and the natives she is studying with the force of an imperial ruler. But while she is as threatening as anything the jungle has to offer, the greatest sacrifices to be made are the ones Dr. Swenson asks of herself and will ultimately ask of Marina. So this is a book that's sent in. It's kind of like a, I don't know if you've heard of the Lost City of Z, but it's kind of where someone goes into the jungle for on a mission and is either dies or never comes back. So this person is sent to find out what's going on. But this sounds really, really neat. It has to do with a drug. It's supposed to be some type of a miracle drug that they're trying to find in this pharmaceutical company. So I just thought it sounded really good. I would imagine it is an adult novel. Okay, here's one I really think is going to be good. Swamplandia by Karen Russell. And it says, author of St. Lucy's Home for Girls Raised by Wolves. So something about that, I don't know, reeks of YA, doesn't it? From the celebrated 29-year-old author, blah, 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 let's see if we can find where this actually starts. Okay. Comes a blazingly original debut novel. This is a debut novel that takes us back to the swamps of the Florida Everglades and introduces us to Ava Big Tree, a unforgettable young heroine. The Big Tree alligator wrestling dynasty is in decline, and Swamplandia, their island home and gator wrestling theme park, formerly number one in the region, is swiftly being encroached upon by a fearsome and sophisticated competitor called the World of Darkness. Ava's mother, the park's indomitable headliner, has just died. Her sister Aussie has fallen in love with a spooky character known as the Dredge Man, who may or may not be an actual ghost. And her brilliant big brother, Kiwi, who dreams of becoming a scholar, has just defected to the world of darkness in a last-ditch effort to keep their family business from going under. Ava's father, affectionately known as Big Chief Big Tree, is A-W-O-L, AWOL, and that leaves Ava, a resourceful but terrified teen, 13, to manage 98 gators and the vast inscrutable landscape of her own grief. So this sounds like a comedy. It sort of sounds like maybe a young adult book. So that sounds good. David McCullough, The Greater Journey, Americans in Paris. I really, really liked this cover. And this is a nonfiction book. I won't go over this too much, but in essence, it is the story of adventurous American artists, writers, doctors, politicians, architects, and others of high aspiration who set off for Paris in the years between 1830 and 1900, ambitious to excel their work. After risking the hazardous journey across the Atlantic, these Americans embarked on a greater journey in the City of Light. Most had never left home, never experienced a different culture. None had any guarantee of success. That they achieved so much for themselves and their country profoundly altered American history. As David McCullough writes, not all pioneers went west. So it's just a really neat, neat book about Americans who did go to Paris, which of course was the place to be. I wanted to show you the end covers on this book. It's an old photograph of a Paris street. Isn't that awesome? I want to see if the back covers have a different... Yes, the back has a different picture. And sets of photographs throughout of some of the different people who visited. There's Henry James, Mary Cassatt, I believe it looks like a painter because that's a self-portrait of her. John Singer Sargent, I don't remember who he is exactly, but there's like three or four of these sets of pictures throughout the whole book. So it just looked really, really good. I was going to get the ebook on this, but then when I saw the physical book and all the pictures, I had to have the physical book. So this is The Magician, and I'm not going to read this because it is the second book in the series by Michael Scott. I'm currently reading The Alchemist right now, and this thing's really dark. So it's The Secrets of the Immortal Nicholas Flamel series. The third book is out right now called The Warlock in hardcover, but since I bought the soft cover of The Alchemist, I'm getting the soft cover of The Magician, and I'll wait till the soft cover comes out for The Warlock. But I do like this cover too. Very nice artwork. This one here, Cubicle Blindness, Krista, showed this recently. I don't know if she actually showed it or not, or it was on Twitter. I don't remember now. It might have been on her haul. Melissa Marr, yeah, it was on her haul because I left a message saying interested in what you think about the book. But I went ahead and bought it. She'll probably read it way before me. Graveminder. Creepy little house there. This sounds really, really neat. This was actually in the science fiction section, not in the young adult, even though I'm sure it's a young adult. It was not in the young adult section. Three Sips to Mind the Dead. Rebecca Barrow never forgot the attention her grandmother Maylene bestowed upon the dead of Claysville, the small town where Beck spent her adolescence. There wasn't a funeral that Maylene didn't attend, and each one Rebecca watched as Maylene performed the same unusual ritual. She took three sips from a silver flask and spoke the words, "Sleep well and stay where I put you." Now Maylene is dead, and Beck must go back, Rebecca Beck, must go back to the place she left a decade earlier. She soon discovers that Claysville is not just the sleepy town she remembers, and that Maylene had good reason for her odd traditions. It turns out that in Claysville, The worlds of the living and the dead are dangerously connected. Beneath the town lies a shadowy, lawless land ruled by enigmatic Charles, a.k.a. Mr. D. Must be Mr. D for death. If the dead are not properly cared for, they will come back to satiate themselves with food, drink, and stories from the land of the living. Only the grave minder, a borrow woman, a borrow, capital B, Rebecca Borrow, sorry about that, that's her name, and her undertaker, in this case Byron Montgomery, with whom Beck shares a complicated past, can set things right once the dead begin to walk. Although she is still grieving for Maylene, Rebecca will soon find that she has more than a funeral to attend to in Claysville, and what awaits her may be far worse: dark secrets, a centuries-old bargain, a romance that still haunts her, and a frightening new responsibility to stop a monster and put the dead to rest where they belong. That sounds absolutely amazing. So, Melissa Marr, Graveminder. And I believe, and Deb will love this, Melissa Marr wrote Wicked Lovely, Ink Exchange, Fragile Eternity, Radiant Shadows, and Darkest Mercy. And I am going to read the Wicked Lovely series, because Debs absolutely loves it. I'm talking about Debs at Debs Book Cafe. So I decided to read that too someday. I believe that's all I have for the long haul. Hope you enjoyed. I have a lot more hauls coming up. Don't know when I'm going to get to them yet, but I don't know. I got home from Barnes & Noble, and I thought I'm just going to get these hauled right away. So I'll see you guys later. Bye.